quick. We gotta turn the channel. I promised my friend Joyce I'd watch the news tonight.
Channel 5, we're there for you. When times are tough, we'll help you through. With news and sports and weather, we'll always be together. We're with you through it all. Channel 5.
Holy that just turned out awful. Joyce, do your thing.
Thanks, Tom. Pornography. The very word conjures up images of red light districts, unprotected sex, and of course, the turn of the century pornograph machine.
Oh, ho, ho, sweet Mary!
But it seems pornography has finally found its way to our neighborhood. Yes, local housewife and church organist Lois Griffin has revealed to this reporter that she appeared in a pornographic movie back in the early 1980s.
What?
Mom, that's you!
Boy, that black bar would be a lot lower now, huh? Huh? Would it not?
Evidently, Lois Griffin, star citizen of Quahog, is also Lois Griffin, star of Quest for Fur. It just goes to show you never know what sort of person is living next door. Tom?
I can't believe this!
Lois, you were in a porno?
She totally betrayed me! I thought girlfriends were supposed to support each other!
Ha! Slut!
How could you do that to me, Joyce?
Oh, hello, Lois.
I told you that in confidence! You totally humiliated me!
Well, then I guess now we're even.
What? What are you talking about? I never did anything to you!
You really don't remember me, do you?
Remember you?
We went to high school together, Lois. Chemistry class, freshman year, Joycey.
You're Joyce Chiva Prava Dumrong?
Yes, but they'd never let that name on TV, so I changed it to Kinney. You ruined my adolescence, Lois. You told me I'd made the cheer squad, blindfolded me, and told me we were going for a special celebration breakfast. When you took the blindfold off, I was standing in front of the entire school with my pants around my ankles and a hot dog in my mouth. It was a horrible thing to do, Lois.
Look, Joyce, that was a long time ago, and I'm very sorry for what I did. But we're adults now, and that doesn't give you any reason to humiliate me like this.
Boo-hoo. You don't like it? You can go talk to a reporter.
Oh, my God. I thought we were friends. The kind of really good friends that communicate with each other poorly through Facebook. Everyone, I think it's important that we talk openly about this. It was back in a disgusting period known as the early 80s. It was a time when women would stand topless, high on coke, on the edge of hotel balconies while the curtains were billowing around them. I think there was actually more wind back then.
Hey, Lois! Get back inside! This coke isn't gonna snort itself!
Great party, Raoul! I feel like I'm hawking all your cocaine.
Hey, that's okay, Lois. You can just buy the next bag, eh? Right, other guy?
Oh, I couldn't afford that. My daddy's making me pay for my own tuition this semester because I maxed out all my credit cards buying a copy of E.T. at the video store. It was $399.
Yeah, but you own it. You can just watch that now. And besides, I got another way you can make money.
So Raoul gave me a job at his pet store, but I still needed money. One day I was cleaning a birdcage and a porn producer came in and, well, the rest you know.
I kind of feel like the part that we should have seen, you know what, never mind, it works.
Good Lord, am I a porn baby?
No, Stewie, come on, I doubt it. I mean, maybe, yeah, probably, yes.